Hey, you guys, welcome back to Married to Film. Listen, here's part two.
Every stud has specific needs, and their owners expect us to meet them. I am not looking for someone to tell me which orders to cut. I want a buyer so I can upgrade my facilities my way. What I don't need is your opinion along with it.
Well, we don't know anything about running a horse farm, so...
I do.
Our only opinion is that you have a very special place here. And we'd like to invest in it. And then perhaps with the financial support, you can turn it into whatever you dreamed it could be.
And you can run the day-to-day, the hirings, the purchasing, all of it.
I'd expect nothing less.
Exactly. So let's just, for 1 minute, let's forget about all the necessary upgrades and the owner expectations. You can do that with anyone's money. What we want to know is, what is your dream for this place?
There is no greater feeling than your own horse coming in.
I bet. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Want to do it?
This whole demeanor, man, is throwing me off.
Tack on another 6% into the investment, and we'll earmark it for this. What do you say?
You in?
You kidding? I haven't gotten an offer like it. Thank you. Yes. Thanks for coming out to the farm today. It's a long drive. You're welcome to spend the night. We have a pretty little guest cottage all made up. Thank you.
Almost like.
The Zeke's hearing is tomorrow afternoon.
We'll get up early. I'll go with you.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we're staying.
Oh, Lord, and your child gonna get in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know Ruth and the casino? I work with her sometimes.
She know not to.
Yeah, I know her. She's cool. I don't really see her, though, because I'm in the office.
I got you. You like it? Working for your parents?
Well. Don't forget to feed Jonah.
What? Yeah, it's fine. It's a summer job.
So how do you guys know each other?
My mom's their parents' lawyer. I normally live in Chicago, but she dragged me here for the summer.
You're Helen Pierce's daughter?
Yeah. You've heard of her?
I should really get you back. My parents are going to be home any second, and they're pretty strict, so.
Yeah. Can I check out the restroom before you throw us
no.
in?
No!
Fine.
Check out?
Yeah. Come on, Jonah, get a gun.
Hey, what are you doing?
Taking a piss.
The bathroom's right there.
What can I say? I wanted to wipe my dick on your parents' sheets.
You good?
No. Why were you in there?
There you go.
All right.
What's going on?
He was using Mom and Dad's bathroom.
So? Don't be weird, Jonah. I think you need to leave.
I'll text you. Go on Saturday. Okay.
Ew!
Cool.
Oh my God.
She's trying to lose her virginity, bro.
We should bring the kids here.
Perv.
Mustache.
You learn how to ride.
It is a perv mustache.
It is.
Are you really okay?
Heck no, you ain't okay.
This doesn't feel like something you get over in a day.
Wendy, this might have been the best thing that could have ever happened. I spent a decade afraid of something, and when it finally arrived, it wasn't at all what I thought it would be.
Uh-oh.
And I wasn't who I thought I would be.
Wow.
What does that mean?
Uh-oh.
It means you were right. Me burying my head in the sand wasn't going to keep us safe. But I figured out what is.
Uh-oh.
What's that?
I'm going to turn Agent Miller. I'm going to put her in her pocket. Mm. That's what I told the warrant. That's what got me out.
Wow. Mm.
The warrant is going to expire in a couple of weeks. If we just wait it out, she'll be gone.
They're going to keep coming back. That's what Maya said. That this is going to be a long play for them.
Maya?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what she said. Years. We'll never know when the hammer's going to fall. And she's very good.
Yep.
I don't know if I can stand in front of her.
Right.
But if we own her, all the anxiety goes away. Wendy, if you want safety, if you want to get the kids out, this is it. You hear me?
Oh, come on. Some of us got shit to do. Where are the bags? You know, getting seen out here ain't good for any of us. fucking hall ass.
Yeah, get him yourself. Because the way we've heard it, you want everyone's jobs anyways.
So. That's the dude, ain't it?
Mm-hmm. Don't lock her up in there.
She wanted to lose her virginity before she went back to school.
That is tricky.
There's something off about him. He was asking tons of questions, and he knows who Helen is. I'm worried that she's gonna find out.
Then lie. It's okay if you're protecting her. She'll find some other.
I think you might have put something in there.
Hey, how do I look?
You probably planted her wire.
Like a very responsible citizen.
God, it's just so sad, you know? I mean, she's got no fucking idea how scary her mom can be.
Oh, no! Mm.
She wanted to get hit. She is trying to steal my baby, just like how she stole my late husband's land for her ugly casino. Drove him into an early grave. I am doing everything right. I'm a good mother. She told you so.
Mrs. Bird, do you have anything to add to your written statement?
Only that I'm really sorry, Darlene. I am not trying to hurt you. We fostered Zeke for a while after his father left, and we love that child. Our kids love him, and we can't just look the other way just because Darlene is our business partner, no matter how uncomfortable that might be. We have to do what's right, not what's easy.
Mr. Langmore.
He gets to tell the truth.
Mrs. Bird was offered to buy Zeke for a cut of their new casino. Mrs. Snell didn't want to. So then Mrs. Bird called her a fucking redneck. And then she just swung at her. It was Miss Bird with the first punch.
Oh, that is a lot. Wyatt, what are you doing? Quiet, please, Mrs. Bird. Now, go on.
Mrs. Snell was just defending Zeke. She was right to. And if you don't mind me saying, Judge, Wendy Bird never has liked us locals. When they first moved here, she threw a dead possum on my house.
Is this true? There were unusual circumstances.
Oh my God, please see her truck.
Yes.
What in the world?
You want to make $15 the hard way?
Very funny. Thanks for coming.
I knew you'd call. Where's this guy live? We're going there right now.
Yeah, you can't.
Yeah, I can't.
Frank Jr. needs a kick in the dick like nobody I've ever met. But you can't. I mean it. He's Casey Ma. Shitbag's untouchable.
Not to me.
To everyone. Seriously. Last time I fucked with him, it cost Marty big.
What'd you do?
I threw him off the top of the boat.
Of course you did.
Is this a mistake?
No, I ordered it.
When?
The day I got back, they shipped it overnight in the morning. Used to play this all the time when I was a kid.
Wow.
Fantastic. I'm very happy for you. But listen, can we get back to Zeke, please, just for 1 minute?
No,
I was so distracted.
Off this game.
When you were gone, I didn't even think to check in on Wyatt. And we should have gotten to the judge, and we should have had our own witness. And the next time, I'm going to have everything aligned.
Oh, hang on.
There's no next time.
You tried your best. We lost. It's time to let go. Okay? We don't need the distraction.
Wow.
Zeke is not a distraction.
Yes, he is. One more person
you
to be responsible
You gave him to
for.
A sociopath. We have to get him back. He's not safe with her.
What? Lord knows she'll protect him.
Right.
And with the way things are, it's probably for the best.
She doesn't actually believe that.
She's distracted.
Marty.
You are not there. Hey, wake up!